Ultrasonic cleaners are one of the most effective methods for cleaning car parts, and I decided to test the effectiveness of a premium device which has heated ultrasonic cleaning and degassing against a regular ultrasonic cleaner which doesn't have these functions. Now let's get this. On the left is my regular device, which has honestly served me well, and next to it is the Creworks 2-liter ultrasonic cleaner, which supports both heating and degassing. I'll be using this water-based engine degreaser, and I'll be testing cleaning of some old spark plugs. First are these two iridium NGK spark plugs. The one on the left appears to be the dirtier of the two. I don't see any differences between the corona stains on both spark plugs. The second set are these Autolite Platinum spark plugs, which look essentially the same, except that the crush washer on the left is rusted. I'll give the tougher job, which is the two on the left, to the Creworks. Let's see if there'll be any difference between the two. I pour in the degreaser into the Creworks. You can actually save some fluid by using water in the main bath while putting your cleaning fluid into a Ziploc bag and immersing the part in it. The ultrasonic cavitations will still be effective, but I'm not going to be doing that today. Next, I set the temperature on the Creworks to 70 degrees centigrade. For the VPCOK, I insert this wire gauze to prevent rupturing the base of the cleaner and then add the fluid. Getting almost close to the target temperature, I turn on the degassing function for some 3 minutes. This helps to expel trapped air in the fluid, which actually impedes the cleaning process. Finally, we're at 70 degrees. It took around 15 to 20 minutes or so to come up to temperature, and it's go time. I place the slightly worse off spark plugs in the heated cleaner, and the other two go into the regular device. Dropping in the cold spark plugs lowered the temperature a bit, and so I turn the heater on again. Although you can set up to an hour cleaning cycle on this Creworks, I'm going to limit it to 30 minutes. For the VPCOK, each cleaning cycle is 5 minutes, so I'll be manually pushing the button as required. Since I'm beginning to see some steam and we're almost at 70 degrees, I turn on the two devices, and right away I can see some ultrasonic action on both machines. For the VPCOK, things seem gentle and you can see the deposits lifting away. However, on the Creworks, things are looking a bit more aggressive, both in terms of the lifting away of deposits and carbon, as well as the vibrations seen on the surface of the fluid. However, the Creworks is definitely the noisier of the two. As mentioned, I pushed the button 6 times on the VPCOK to get to 30 minutes of cleaning, and once the devices were off, the spark plugs come out. Let's inspect closely. You can definitely see that the corona stain on the iridium spark plug on the right is gone, while it still persists on the spark plug on the left. It's also clear that the threads on the iridium are cleaner on the right. We still have some hard carbon deposits on the iridium spark plug on the left. I don't see any differences between these Autolite Platinum spark plugs. Your verdict is as good as mine. The heated ultrasonic cleaner definitely has the most action. However, not everyone needs or is ready to spend so much on premium cleaners. If you're a shop, definitely this makes the most sense. However, the VPCOK is still a good device, and I'll continue to use it and only pull out the Creworks where required. I have some links down in the description and in the comments for both products in case you want to check them out. Hope this has been helpful. Do like, share and subscribe if it has. Also remember to turn on notifications while at it, and I'll catch you on the next one. Peace.